In our parasha, the Torah comments, Tzedek, tzedek tirdof, justice, justice, you should pursue. Our sages question the repetitiveness of the word justice and explain that each word comes to teach a different concept. The first tzedek teaches that the judges should judge righteously whenever an argument comes before them. And the second tzedek teaches that they should sometimes instruct the people fighting to compromise. The example the Gemara gives is of two boats who come simultaneously to a narrow intersection in the ocean. While only one of them can pass, who will have the right of way? The Gemara answers that if one boat is carrying a load and the second is empty, the loaded boat comes through first. This is how you judge righteously. If they are both equally loaded or equally empty, however, we instruct them to compromise somehow. At the meeting of the great sage the Chazon Ish with the first prime minister of Israel, Ben Gurion, the latter asked the Chazon Ish how the non-religious would be able to live at the same land together with the religious while conducting such a different lifestyle. The Chazon Ish replied with the above Gemara of the boats, explaining that since the religious are coming with a loaded baggage of Torah, mitzvot, and minhagim, while the non-religious come empty-handed, therefore the religious should lead the way. But this argument of the Chazon Ish is seemingly strange, as answering someone who isn't religious with a religious source is meant to fall on deaf ears. But the truth is that when everyone is completely convinced in their beliefs and they say it with confidence and conviction, the one listening accepts the message. It's interesting to note that Ben Gurion himself used this very technique when he needed to convince the nations of the right of the Jews to the land of Israel. He said that our historic right to the land is not derived from the declaration of Balfour or the acceptance of the UN, but rather it derived straight from the Bible, who explicitly says so. How did he speak to the world in our biblical terms? Since he was completely convinced of our right to the land, he was able to deliver the message right at the target. We learn from here that when we need to talk to others, the measure of them accepting our words lies in the beliefs and confidence we have in ourselves when we speak to them. Shabbat Shalom.
שלום, שמי הרב שי תחן, ואני מקווה שנהניתם והחכמתם מהשיעור. אם יש לכם שאלה בהלכה, פנו אלינו לבית ההוראה במספר 347-666-3467. זה מספר בניו יורק, ולכן תוכלו לשאול במספר של וואטסאפ, והרבנים של בית ההוראה, ואני בכללם, ננסה לענות לכם בהקדם. שבת שלום.